Now, good morning, student of standard 5. Welcome to my class. So, children, I am going to start my today's session. The topic is properties. Properties of division of decimal numbers. So here, children, all of you see that firstly, first property, division of a decimal number by 1. Whenever a decimal number is divided by 1, then the number is the quotient is the number itself. Whenever a decimal number is divided by 1, then the quotient is the number, decimal number itself. For example, 4.8, it is divided by 1. So what is the quotient? 4.8. So when a decimal number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. This is the first property. Now come to the second property. Division by of 0. Division of 0 by a decimal number. Decimal number. Whenever 0 is divided by decimal number, the quotient is 0. When 0 is divided by a decimal number, the quotient is 0. For example, 0 divided by 0.41. Here the answer is 0. 0 divided by 1.9. The answer is 0. So, 0 divided by, when the 0 is divided by a decimal number, the quotient is 0. This is the second property. And the third property is, when a decimal number is divided by the same decimal number, then the quotient is 1. For example, when a decimal number is divided by the same decimal number, then the quotient is 1. Okay, decimal number divided by itself is 1. Decimal number divided by itself is 1. Now let us, for example, .3 divided by 0.3. Here the quotient is 1. 5.21 divided by 5.21. Quotient is 1. Okay? Right? Now come to the worksheet number 12. So here in question worksheet number 12, now come to question number 1. Fill in the boxes. So here first I am going to give you 9.85 divided by 1 is equal to what? So, first property, whenever a decimal number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. So, answer is 9.85. Now, come to B. So, dash divided by 0.3 3 is equal to 1. So when a decimal number is divided by itself, the quotient is 1. So here the dividend is the same decimal number as a divisor, right? So similarly, children, you have to do this worksheet number 12. Come to see, dash divided by 1.3, it is equal to 0. So whenever 0 is divided by a decimal number, the quotient is 0. Correct? So children, your classwork is you have to do worksheet number 12. So here children, now come to the question worksheet number 13. So in worksheet number 13, let us start first question. 12 tins can hold 39.624 liters of oil. 12 tins can hold 39.624 liters of oil. How much oil can one tin hold? 12 tins can hold 39.624 liters of oil. How much oil can one tin hold? So here you have to find out, children, the quantity of oil that one tin can hold. So here come to, this is worksheet number 13. So come to the first problem. So what is the number of tins? Number of tins is equal to 12. Okay? And the quantities, total quantity of oil is equal to 39.624 liter. So what you have to find out, the capacity of one tin, that is equal to 39.624 divided by 12, right? So here you have to do division. So how you will do, 39.624 will be divided by 12, right? So here we will start from the extreme left side. So here I am going to start with 3. So 0 times of 12 is 0. So 3 minus 0 is 3. So here it is 39, right? So 3 times of 12 is 36. So 39 minus 36 is 3. Now here, after this, there is a decimal. So decimal will go just above it. Right? Now come, write down this 6. So 12 threes are 36. So 36 minus 36 is 0. Now we put down this 2. Correct? So 2 is smaller than 12. So I will multiply with 0. So 12 zeros are 0. 2 minus 0 is 2. Now we put down this 4, it is 24. So 2 times of 12 is 24. So 24 minus 24 is 0. So what is the capacity of one tin? It is 3.302 liters. This is the answer. So capacity of one tin is 3.302. Now let us come another question.
Now come to B. Cost of 23 meter of cloth is 608.35. Find the cost of 1 meter cloth. Cost of 23 meter of cloth is 608.35. Find the cost of 1 meter cloth.
So here, children, all of you see that the cost of, come to B. Cost of 23 meter of cloth is equal to rupees 608.35, and you have to find out cost of 1 meter cloth. So what you will do? It is equal to 608.35 divided by 23. So whenever you will divide 608.35 by 23, you will get the answer of cloth cost of 1 meter cloth. So let us divide it. 608.35 is divided by 23. So let us start with this 6. 6 is less than 23. So we'll multiply with 0. 23 zeros are 0. Now it put out 60. Now we will multiply with 2. 2 threes are 6. 2 twos are 4. Now we will do subtraction. It is 4 and 1. Now we put down here 8. Right? 148. Now here I will multiply with 6. 6 threes are 18. 8 1. 6 twos are 12. 1 13. So it is 10. Right? Now after that, after 8, it is decimal is here. Put decimal here. Now we put down this 3. So start with 3. Start with 4. 4 threes are 12, 2, 1. 4 twos are 8, 1, 9. So minus it. So it is 1, 1. Now it will be 5 will come. 115. Now multiply with 5. 5, 3s are 15, 1, 5, 2s are 10, 1, 11. So answer is 0. So here quotient is, what is the cost of 1 meter cloth? It is 26.45 rupees. So this is the answer. So children, in this way, you will do question number B. Now let us come to the question number C.
So here in question number C, I have a 7.5 meter long ribbon. I want to cut it into 1.5 meter long pieces. How many pieces will I get? I have a 7.5 meter long ribbon. I want to cut it into 1.5 meter long pieces. How many pieces will I get?
So here, children, you have to do again division. So let us explain it. Now come to question number C. What is the length of the ribbon? Length of a ribbon, it is equal to what? It is equal to 7.5 meter, right? So I want to cut it into 1.5 meter long pieces. So the length, how many pieces will I get? So the length of one piece is equal to 1.5 meter. So here question is, how many pieces you will get? So number of pieces is equal to what? So here 7.5 is divided by 1.5. Okay, so what is the answer? Answer is 5 pieces. Correct? So in this way, children, you have to do the this worksheet number 13. So now let us come to the next question, question number D. So in question number D,
D is 16.5 kilogram sugar is put in a paper bags, each containing 0.5 kilogram of it. 16.5 kilogram sugar is put in a paper bags, each containing 0.5 kilogram of it. How many bags are there? So you have to find out the number of bags. So what you will do? I'm just giving you the hint.
So here, children, in question number D, what you will do? So what is the quantity of sugar? Total quantity of sugar? Quantity of sugar is equal to what? It is 16.5 kilogram, right? And each bag containing 0.5 kilogram of it, and capacity of each bag means one bag is equal to 0.5 kilogram. So you have to find out number of bags. Okay, so what you will do? 16.5 will be divided by 0.5. So after this you will get the number of bags. Okay children, now come to question number E.
So in E, what is the question? I require 2.25 meter cloth to stitch a skirt. I require 2.25 meter cloth to stitch a skirt. How many skirts can be stitched with 20.25 meter cloth? I require 2.25 meter cloth to stitch a skirt. How many skirts can be stitched with 20.25 meter cloth?
So here children, what you have to do? Just I am giving you the hint in question number E. So here all of you see that in this question I require how much cloth is needed for one skirt? It is 2.25 meter, and total cloth is, total length of the cloth is equal to 20.25 meter. So number of skirt is equal to, you have to do 20.25 meter will be divided by 2.25 meter, then you will get the answer. So children, in this way you have to do worksheet number 13. So what is your c work is worksheet number 13, and H work is worksheet number 12. So children, I think each and every questions are discussed here in this video. So I think, hope you will be able to solve the answer. So children, bye bye. Till then, goodbye.